Until now, we have considered all the training samples for each iteration of the gradient descent. So we are taking one small step. After that, we are taking another step, third iteration, fourth iteration. For each iteration, we are using all training samples of the gradient descent. Finally, we are getting the minimum value of the cost function. But what if our training samples are very large? If our training samples are 5 lakhs, then taking the 5 lakhs training samples for every iteration makes computationally more expensive. So is there any alternative? Yes, as we already discussed in the machine learning, there are two concepts. One is mini batch gradient descent and next one is stochastic gradient descent. In the mini batch gradient descent, now what is batch? Batch is nothing but whatever the training sample size, training samples number we are using for a single iteration of a gradient descent, we are calling that as a batch. If we are using 5 lakhs training samples, then it is a batch gradient descent because we are using the entire batch. Instead of that, now we want to use mini batch gradient descent. What is this mini batch gradient descent? We are dividing these 5 lakhs training samples into 5,000 mini batches. In every batch, we are having 1,000 training samples. Now we have 5,000 mini batches. Each batch is consisting 1,000 training samples. When we are giving this, when we are giving each training set, each mini batch set, we can call as each mini batch set for our gradient descent. In the first iteration, the gradient descent computes for the first 1,000 training samples, and in the second iteration, it computes for next 1,000 training samples. Like that, it will proceed. Instead of considering 5 lakhs training examples for every sample, it is very computationally effective process. So in this vectorization process, we will take the matrix capital X. The matrix is having only 1,000 columns. Instead of 5 lakhs columns, it is now having only 1,000 columns. And how many number of iterations you want to perform? 5,000 iterations you want to perform. Why 5,000 perform iterations? Because we have taken 5,000 mini batches. We want to perform 5,000 iterations. In this process, we are getting the minimum value of the cost function. Now, as we discussed, whenever we want to check the gradient or whenever we want to check whether we are getting the proper minimization or not, with the increment of the iterations, the cost function value should decrease. It is the only indication. If, for example, in the first iteration, if the cost function value is some 1,000, in the second iteration, it should decrease at least by 990. Or something below 1,000. In the 10th iteration, you can definitely say the value should be less than 1,000. If in the 10th iteration, the value is coming some around 1,100, then you can say there is an error. Whether you have not considered the alpha properly or there is some error, you have to look back. So the criterion is whenever the number of iterations are increasing, the cost function value should decrease. Now, this exactly happens in the batch gradient descent. But whereas in mini batch gradient descent, you can observe here, many times the curve is oscillating. Why this oscillation is happening? Because in the first batch, we are using 1,000 examples. In the second batch, we are using another 1,000 training samples. So the training samples we are using are not matching. So that's why sometimes the cost function value may increase, sometimes it may decrease. But one thing is sure, when we are taking all iterations, by the end of the iterations, if we look at the curve, the cost function value should decrease in totality. We should get curve like this, which is indicating that our mini batch gradient descent is working properly. If you really want the minimum value, then we should go for the batch gradient descent. But if you are expecting computationally efficient thing, if you are expecting the process should not be slow, then you can go with the mini batch gradient descent. If we are taking the mini batch only one, means we are taking only one training sample at a time for the gradient descent, then it is called as stochastic gradient descent. But we may not tell when we use the stochastic gradient descent, there is no guarantee that definitely we will get the minimum value of the cost function. We may not tell whether it is converged or whether it will not, because sometimes we are using that one training sample, sometimes it will give some value of j. We are using another training sample, sometimes it will give the value greater than j, sometimes less than j. It does not guarantee the convergence of the cost function. But when we use the mini batch gradient descent compared to the stochastic gradient descent, it will definitely give the confirmation for the convergence. This is the batch gradient descent. You can observe we have started first iteration here. Definitely with the confirmation we can tell that in the second iteration the value of the cost function is decreasing. If it is not decreasing, then there is a problem whether with the alpha or something. But if you have considered all the hyperparameters properly, then definitely the cost function value should decrease with every iteration. But there is no guarantee in the stochastic gradient descent. For every iteration, we may not tell, because in every iteration we are using only one training sample. That's why you may not guarantee. And finally, about the convergence also, there is no guarantee. So you can observe this curve. Sometimes it is going in this contour plot. You can observe sometimes the value of cost function is increasing, decreasing. Sometimes some random arbitrary curve it is taking. Whereas if we consider the mini batch gradient descent, you observe here. Compared to stochastic gradient descent, the chances for convergence of the mini batch gradient descent is high, because we are taking 1,000 training or more than one training examples in every iteration. So the disadvantage with the batch gradient descent is it is taking a long amount of time for every iteration, because we are considering all training examples. But it will definitely give the advantages. It will definitely give the minimum value. Whereas stochastic gradient descent, it is very fast process, but we may not guarantee always it is giving the minimum value. Now, the mini batch gradient descent, it is the compromise between the batch gradient descent and stochastic gradient descent. The first point, it is not taking that much amount of time for every iteration compared to batch gradient descent. And second point, compared to stochastic gradient descent, the chances of convergence in the mini batch gradient descent are high. We are taking only in this example 1,000 training samples for every iteration. So in the vectorization, we are using only 1,000 training samples. So matrix with 1,000 columns, it is very simple. But if you want to operate a matrix consisting of 5 lakhs columns, can we assume that? It is very difficult process. So with the modern data, huge data samples, always we may not have sophisticated processors to handle the data, or sometimes the training samples may be in crores. Then at that time we want to take the mini batch gradient descent, we have to divide the data into mini batches. We give the first batch for the first iteration, second batch for the second iteration, like that. If with the as the number of iterations are progressing, as the number of iterations are going, if the cost function value is decrementing, that itself is giving the indication that the hyperparameters you have considered are proper, and the mini batch size you have considered are proper, and your mini batch gradient descent is definitely going to converge at some point of time. It is an indication. Okay. So this is how we use the mini batch gradient descent whenever we are having the huge number of training data. If you are having training data only 1,000 training samples, then there is no need to look for the mini batch gradient descent. Dividing 1,000 training samples is not a advisable thing. You can directly go with the 1,000 training samples for every iteration. But only when you are having a large amount of data, as modern day we are going with the incrementing data. When we are having a large amount of input training data, then you can go for the mini batch gradient descent.